Hi, I'm Suzanne Smalley with Atlas RFID, and we're here at RFID Journal Lab 2014. I'm here with Ed Nabrotsky. How are you doing today?
Just fantastic. End of the show. It's always a good day.
Oh, yes, definitely. Getting a little tired. Yeah. All right. Well, what have you have going on in the Omni booth? We know you have a ton of new products. You're up for Best in Show for the demo. So what have you got here? What you got in your hand?
Well, this is one of our feature products, and it is actually the Best in Show finalist for Best Product of the Year.
Okay.
And this is our V10. It's an extension of our famous visual tagging family. OmniID's brought a new concept to the market called visual tagging. It allows you to have RFID tags that actually show operator-readable instructions on them.
Oh.
And as we've been launching those with a number of key customers, our customers have said, those little tags are great in label size, but I've got a lot of work instructions that are paper size, sheet size, and I'd love a product that would do that, that's trackable, that also can do that, that kind of function. So we created the V10, the first in the world trackable tablet-size tag.
Awesome, okay. So it's just a tag.
Mm-hmm. People look at it and think that it's a tablet, but of course it's not a tablet, and that's key to our customers. You can't run apps on it, you can't do web browsing, and our factory customers love that because they don't want their employees doing things like that. It's built for purpose. But the fact that you've got an e-paper screen in here means that it's got very long battery life. You can use it for 2.5 to 3 weeks in your continuous flow environment without recharging.
Wow.
And that's really important. Tablet trials they've done only let them get through a shift or less than a shift.
Right.
And that's very annoying. The other thing that's really key about that is that if you shut down your line on Friday at the end of work and you come back on Monday, you don't want to boot cycle or have to download or put things back up. You want to carry on where you left off.
Right.
This will hang there all weekend long, not burning any battery, showing the same image. When you show up to work on Monday morning, you can start right away with the same work instruction, even if the network doesn't come back up, because it's all stored right inside.
So it's just ready to go.
It's ready to go right away.
Awesome.
The other thing that's really cool about it is you've got infrared sensor built into it, so it can take infrared triggers. It also has, of course, UHF RFID. And what that means is, where in the past, a build book had to come to a workstation and the worker had to flip to the right page, it recognizes its location by the beacon codes it receives, either through infrared or RFID, and it turns already the page the worker needs to see. That has two great benefits, of course. It means that the worker automatically sees what he's supposed to do, but it also means it's seeing where the asset is, and you get immediate visibility to your work in process inventory as they flow through the plant. So those triggers are a really, really important part of the whole features of the device. We've chosen to focus on manufacturing as a key market, but we have a lot of partners that do other markets. And one market in particular, healthcare, where there's a lot of money being spent on electronic patient records, really wants this kind of a product. So we've partnered with a number of companies that are interested in taking it in. That was a big part of why the infrared was so important. In hospital and healthcare, they often put an infrared emitter in a room, and when you walk into the room, the V10 will know exactly what room it's in and display the appropriate record for the room.
Well, that is awesome. That's
really,
great for
really
the healthcare
cool.
industry.
What's great for us is that we had a key customer at the show yesterday that gave a keynote speech, Daimler.
Okay.
And Daimler's engine plant in Michigan has adopted the V10. They're one of our first customers that's gone on record to talk about it. So they're automating their process using the V10, building all their engines paperless. And he gave a great keynote address on that yesterday and explained the benefits and why Daimler's so excited about this technology.
Oh, that is so cool.
It's really cool. So it also has 5 capacitive touch buttons, which you can see as I press these buttons, which aren't really being pressed because they're just capacitive, you get a page flip that indicates the unit has received the signal. These buttons can be soft keyed, of course. You see the soft keys on the bottom. So every page could be formatted to mean different things. It could be a replenishment signal saying I'm out of parts, bring me parts. It could be an emergency signal saying I've broken my leg, help. It could be any number of things, a quality hold, a blemish that's on the product. So there's operator feedback built in here as well.
Okay.
So it's really an interesting product, a big step for OmniID to make something like this that can be rugged, can be dropped to concrete, can be immersed in water, sprayed down. We think it's going to be a fantastic product, and we've already got it in trials with a lot of big customers.
Well, awesome. It looks really, really, really cool, and I know it's building on what y'all had last year.
Yes.
In-house, so
let me show you a little bit of that while we're talking about it.
Yeah.
So this is what we had last year. These are our most popular visual tags, the 3-inch tag and the 4-inch tag. But unlike last year, you'll see there's a couple little changes to them. We've also added some buttons to the tag. There's 2 buttons here, membrane switch buttons on the V4.
Oh,
pressing that one. And there's 1 button here on the V3. So we offer these now in different button configurations. And that adds an extra power to the visual tagging. Now, in addition to seeing the instructions, being able to track it as it goes through the plant with RFID, operators can also signal things, calling for replenishment, signaling line conditions. That's been a very powerful additional feature for some of our customers in how they use it.
That's really cool. So you've got one on the smaller one, 1 button,
mm-hmm.
and then on the bigger one you have the 2 for
That's right.
different controls.
Yep. For the two small sizes, we can only really fit one button in, right. And when they need more than one button, they have to move up to the 4-inch size. And of course, on the 10-inch size, we've got 5 buttons.
Also, I was saying, and then move to the next level.
We're trying very hard for our marketing not to fall in the trap of having an extra cup holder on every door like they do on some minivans, right? So we will try not to get beyond 5 buttons.
Well,
but the buttons
I'll
are very important.
I'll hold
you
to it. All right, so what are y'all, what's going on over here?
Let me show you this computer because it's a part of OmniID that most people don't think about. When we made the decision to get into visual tagging, we recognized that there was no one in the market doing visual tagging, and there's unique things about formatting images and controlling images back and forth that there wasn't software to support it.
Right.
And so we had to create our own software structure and develop a whole capability in OmniID to build software.
Okay.
And this is our software product called OmniAT, standing for Asset Track. This is a demo that's on a continuous scroll, of course, for the booth, but this shows you a nice Silverlight interface that we've developed for this. It's obviously able to be multi-tenant, to be able to be hosted in the cloud, although many of our customers want it hosted locally. That Silverlight interface allows us to have good web client access, so you can attach with any IP web client and be able to look at your assets, program your locations, send images down to tags, but also track passive tags going through your facility. Many of our customers are hybrid customers that want multiple types of tags. So Asset Track's being built to be able to track all those different things. It's a very early stage for Asset Track as a software package, but it's a very reliable package already being installed in several major accounts to help control these tags, and the package capabilities continues to expand. But it's currently on release number 1.3, and this is 1.3 being shown right here.
Well, that is awesome, and you can do passive and active. That's
yes,
OmniID really
is now, we've expanded our package now that we do passive, battery-assisted passive, active, and visual tags.
Right.
So we have the broadest tag selection in the industrial marketplace, all hardened, all made for rugged environments, and this tool can talk to all of those at the same time. So in customers like Daimler, who spoke yesterday, mm-hmm. we're doing 3 different projects with them. We have a dunnage project where we're tracking their totes coming in. They have about 100,000 totes coming through their facility, and those totes have just passive tags on them. Some of their larger crates have an active tag with a visual screen on them to tell forklift drivers where to take them. So there's a combination in the dunnage. And then on their line side, they have call buttons to be able to do call buttons for replenishment and conditions. So we've added that. And then on their engine build, they have the V10. All of these together can work together through one software object and report back up to their SAP system.